गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर स्टडिंग अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 12, अ बैड ड्रीम. सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर अप टू हियर वी हैव स्टडीड दैट फ्रॉम बैंक टू पीपल, मिस्टर ब्रिग्स एंड विंटर, दे केम टू मिस्टर हिल टू टेल हिम दैट ही शुड रिजाइन. ओके, सो लास्ट लाइन्स वी हैव स्टडीड, विंटर वॉज सेइंग दैट यू डोंट वर्क हार्ड सर. Then Mr. Hill, he was arguing, of course I do hard work. Then Briggs, he said, oh no sir, for example you come late in the morning, Winter, and you often leave early. Now they were saying that in the morning you come late and in the evening you leave early, Briggs, and you take 2 or 3 hours for lunch. We spend all day in the bank but you are never there. So here Briggs was saying, and sir, your lunch time also is very elongated. You take 2-3 hours for lunch, and we are, you know, every time we are in bank, we spend our all day in the bank, but you are not there. Mr. Hill, but I am the manager, that's part of my job. I have to look after important people, I have to have lunch with them, it's good for business. Then Mr. Hill, he replied to it. He told them, I am the manager, that's a part of my job, because I have to entertain people also, I have to take lunch with them, because it is good for business. Now Briggs said, it's pleasure sir, you are very fond of good food. So he said, it's not your work sir, it's your pleasure, it's your nature that you like good food. Mr. Hill, I won't listen to this. Then Winter said, but you must. Then Mr. Hill, he got angry. He said, I don't want to listen these things. Then Winter said, but sir, you are supposed to listen to these things. Mr. Hill, I shall write to the head office about you. Then you will have to resign. Then Mr. Hill, he got angry. He said, I am going to write about your behavior to head office. And then you will be the one who will resign. Briggs, we have already written about you, sir. Winter, yes, sir. We explained the matter and they agreed with us. Then Briggs told him, sir, you can't write about us because we have already written about you in the head office. Then Winter said, and we have explained everything to them and they also support us. Mr. Hill, what? You have written to the head office behind my back? Then Mr. Hill, he was shocked. He said, you have written to the head office and I don't know about it. Briggs, we have to do it, sir. We were only thinking of the bank. Then Briggs said, sir, we had to do because we were thinking for the betterment of the bank. Winter, and they agree you must resign? Winter said, and they agreed, sir. They supported us, yes, that you should resign. Mr. Hill, but they can't do this to me. I have spent 30 years in the bank. Then Mr. Hill, he was shocked. He said, how they can do this to me? I have spent my precious 30 years in the bank and now they are doing this to me? Briggs, think of the bank, sir. It will be a happier place without you. Then Brig again said to him that, sir, please think of a bank. It would be a happy place without you. Mr. Hill, but what am I going to do? I am not a young man. How can I find a new job? Then again Mr. Hill said, but okay, if I would resign, then what will I do for my livelihood? I am not a young man. How am I going to find a new job? Winter, oh, you will find something, sir, a job in an office. Briggs, and you can have time, sir. 2 or 3 months, you will be able to find a new job. And then Briggs told him, sir, bank is going to give you time, 2-3 months. Then in the meantime, you can find a job. Mr. Hill, I'm not sure. Briggs, but you promise to resign, don't you, sir? Hill, well, I must. The head office agrees with you. Winter, thank you, sir. Briggs, we are sorry about this, sir. Then They both told him about everything. Then Mr. Hill agreed to resign because they have already talked about him in the head office. Then Briggs and Winter stand up. So they both stood up. Briggs, you will come to office tomorrow, won't you, sir? Mr. Hill, oh yes, I will be there, Winter, but please come on time, sir. Then, Briggs, he said to him that tomorrow you are coming to bank, na? Then, Mr. Hill said, yeah, I will be there. Then, Winter, he reminded him, but please, sir, be on time. Then, Briggs and Winter say good afternoon and go out. Mr. Hill sits with his head in his hands. After a time, Mrs. Hill comes in. She is wearing a heavy coat and she has a bag in her hand. So, you know, as they both, Briggs and Winter, they bid goodbye to Mr. Hill. Mr. Hill was so worried. He was sitting like that only. He was thinking. And at that time, he saw Mrs. Hill. She came in. She was wearing a heavy coat and there was a bag in her hand. She was going somewhere. Mr. Hill looking up. Oh, it's you, dear. Briggs and Winter were here. They left a short time ago. So Mr. Hill told her that Briggs and Winter came here and now only they have left. Mrs. Hill, yes, I saw them when they were going out. Mr. Hill, they came to tell me something. It isn't very pleasant. After a moment, I have to resign from bank. Mr. Hill, he revealed everything to Mrs. Hill. That they both came to talk to me about my resignation. Mrs. Hill said, yes, I know that. Mr. Hill, he was surprised. Do you know already? She said, yes, they told me. They informed me about this earlier also. Mr. Hill, they could not wait. Did they tell you the reason too? Then he asked, have they told you the reason also? Mrs. Hill, yes, the people in the bank don't like you. I am not very surprised. I have spent all my life in the bank and now I have lost my job. So Mrs. Hill said, I know that many people in the bank, they don't like you. And I am not surprised by this because you are like that only. Mr. Hill said, I have spent my whole life for the bank, in the bank. But now see, I have lost my job. What they are doing to me? Mr. Hill notices that his wife is wearing a coat. Means, you know, when they used to go out, that's at that time they used to wear a coat. Because in houses, temperature is maintained. Mr. Hill. Oh, are you going out? He sees the bag too. And you have got a bag. Where are you going? Then he noticed the luggage also. He asked him, where are you going? Mrs. Hill. I need a holiday. I'm going to spend a few days with my sister. So Mrs. Hill, she replied that I want a break. I want holiday. So I'm going to spend some days with my sister. Mr. Hill, at this time, but I need help now. But this time, in my difficult time, you are leaving me. I need your help now. Mrs. Hill, I can't help you and I must have a holiday. I can't wait. So she replied, I am no one to help you. I can't help you. I need a holiday. I am leaving. But you can have a holiday later. We will go together. Then he proposed that, you know, afterwards also we can go. We both will go on a holiday. Where will you get the money for a holiday? You have lost your job. It won't be easy to find a new one. You are not a young man. Then she argued back. Then, from where you are going to get money from for holidays? You have lost your job. And how you are able to find a new job? Because you are not a young man. I have got 3 months. I'll find something. So he told him, I have got the time of 3 months. In the meantime, I will be able to find something. Then she said, I hope you are right. Then Mr. Hill said, you are leaving me because I am in trouble. When are you coming back? And then he asked him, that when you are going to coming back, she said, I have no idea. I will write and let you know. But who is going to look after me? Mrs. Hill, there is Annie. Speak to her nicely and perhaps she will stay. Well, good boy, George. Write to me when you have a job. So students, up to here only we will study, you know. You can see the turns and twists in the story that they were firing Annie, but now Mr. Hill has fired from the bank. So students, rest of the chapter we will study in the next video. Till then, revise the chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.